Welcome. You are about to take a journey to a place of the divine love within with Deborah Beauvais on the Love by Intuition show. For the next hour, allow her to prepare you in becoming a magnet for a profound love-infused relationship by identifying and focusing on solutions through love. Awaken the light within and let your essence shine. And now, here's Deborah Beauvais on Love by Intuition, all part of the Dream Vision 7 radio network.
Welcome, everyone. Bonjour, mes amis. And yes, here I am, as I always say, Deborah Beauvais, founder and owner of the Dream Vision 7 radio network. If you're tuning in for the first time, we are Boston-based, internet syndicated. You can listen to us wherever you are in the world. You can use the apps, you can ask Alexa, you can listen in the car, all these kinds of things. We have all the bells and whistles. And you can listen to the Love by Intuition show Monday through Friday, 6 a.m. and 6 p.m. when we're usually live. And I have to say, oh, and before I even get into my guest, always like to share that we are the media partner for the Omega Institute in Rhinebeck, New York. And we have three workshops that you're able to get 20% off because of our partnership. You, the listener, you, whether you're listening today, tomorrow, next week, they are open from May to October. So I have the most wonderful, beautiful, precious guest. She has, I can't say enough about her because we met eons ago and we reconnected recently, and I just am in awe of KARENDAYAL’S, that Devi is her name, and she's local here in Rehoboth for years, and now she's out in Warren, Rhode Island, and we are going to be talking about her work. We are going to be finding out why she's so special. But KARENDAYAL’S is your life's river guide for mind, body, soul care with her practical East meets West vibe. She has been immersed in the ancient healing arts since the age of 5 and has been in professional service since 1993. She is all about love, peace, truth, joy, and happiness. Through her life-changing and supporting soul self-mastery coaching for healing, transformation, and empowerment. She is the founder and owner of Bliss Life Yoga and Wellness, created the movement Release, Reclaim, Rise, Be You, Live Love for her signature transformational soul mastery, soul self-mastery program, designed specifically for you and your self-discovery journey. I have actually experienced many healing at such levels that one would never imagine, but we'll get into that. Without further ado, KARENDAYAL’S, welcome to the show.
Hi, dear one. Hi, Deborah. Thank you so much for inviting me. It's so great to hear your voice and to reconnect in this way again. It's beautiful.
Yes. And so I just want to let everyone know that the kinds of healings that you do are so profound. And I've done a lot of different healing modalities. I'm a practitioner of reconnective healing myself. But you, dear one, you have a special gift. I recall one of the times, and I probably brought this up before, one of the times we were together and you were doing some healing modalities with me, that Rick, my late husband, came through at such such a deep way, and in that, I stayed in that frequency. I don't know if I ever told you, but I stayed in that higher frequency for 2 days, and it was extremely hard to focus on anything because I was just vibrating at such a high level, and it was something that I've had some profound experiences, and that one is right up there. So I still think about that.
It is. It's beautiful, isn't it? And when we get those kind of healing connections, and a lot of the work that I do is not just the actual, almost technique, right? Because we say, I've been trained in like a bazillion things. I've been put on this planet for sure to do what I'm doing. And then I have, I guess one can say, right, has been gifted with, an essence that's just deep, intuition as well. And to be able to tap into, like, I don't know what we can call it, in between the veils, in between the worlds, right? The soul.
Yes.
And literally, that energy essence, when we're doing the work with people, it's not just always here, and it is, what gets brought in between the veils, and it is does get brought in, through people who have passed on and what have you. And then the work that we need to do on ourselves, and they help assist that too sometimes, and so to be able to have those great initiations like you did during some of the sessions, it's absolutely incredible. It proves and shows who we really are, right? Because as human beings, we're so multi-layered and multifaceted and dimensional, and it only just, right, it proves to us when we have these kind of experiences that are for real, and right, and it's like we don't need charts and graphs or anything to prove anything. We had our own experience, and we know, and the deep, profound healing that it takes us to layer upon layer. Yeah, it's incredible.
Yes, it is. So let's talk about, you started connecting at these levels when you were just 5. So can you tell us a little bit about what that was like? And then please talk about your brother Kevin and where he is today. And I know through the love and you facilitating at such a young age is how he thrived, through love and healing.
Right. Yeah, he's definitely my roots. Yep, when Deborah speaks of Kevin, that's my brother. And long story short, I mean, this is how I know I'm doing the work today. And that I was literally born in, to a family that was like, here you go. Obviously, I asked for it before getting here, right? And got born right into the initiation that I got initiated into. But long story short, he was only given like 2 years to live at birth. He was born with something called Wernicke-Hoffmann's disease, and it's the cells that go to your muscles just deteriorate and die. And so, so it was really like, we have nothing to offer. But yet, at the same time, then this whole other world opened up, and it was more what we would call today, the alternative healing world or natural or, whatever word people want to give it that's other than, and I say it should be, it's right there. It's what we do. But anyways, the fact that he was supposed to die and had nothing at all to offer, it was through these ways. It was literally through a chiropractor first that had him holding his head up in one visit where his head couldn't be held up. And then from there, it was literally, you name it, acupuncture, massage, and energy healing, and all of that, because what it is managing energy in the body. And when the body can't do it itself physically, then we need to kind of pump it, right? And like let it, like facilitate it when it's not doing it on its own. And really the life force, if you will, right, is literally, we're here or we're not, right? That breath that we experience, what rides in with that breath is that spark, right, that allows us to be here. And so if we have a physical body that isn't functioning properly to the fullest, and then we're trying all these different modalities and what have you, right, to make it work or have it work, that was literally the landscape of how I grew up. Because then right away, he was my first teacher, first guinea pig, first student, everything. I, since 5 years old, vividly got to see through a real live human being what works and what doesn't work, and why the workings of our mind and the energy is everything. Because we could have, and he could have just accepted the, yes, I'm going to die, or yes, my body doesn't work this way, and continue to deteriorate. Or, literally took a different approach, and then through taking that different approach, opened up a whole nother way to be able to continue to vibrate and thrive, if you will, you know. And I look back on times, oh, my God, yeah, I mean, there was healing sessions we would have for him, you know, and everything that when things really just weren't working, you know, right, as we would say. And then it was through those healing circles and laying of the hands and the energy work and the prayers along with, you know, the acupuncture and all these different modalities, right, to keep that life force moving. And it's what was able to happen. So when you fast forward it throughout the years, he's 46 now. He lives in Nashville, and he's got personal care attendants around the clock. He's still, you know, he's in his motorized wheelchair. And honestly, if you write down everything he has on paper, he's like dead, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And the spine is on the side of his body instead of down the back. And, you know, oxygenation in his body is not, you know, would be like off the charts to say how can a human being live like this. So he's so unique. And so he graduated, you know, high school. He graduated with a master's degree in psychology. He went to go write country music. And so he goes through life, you know, like I always say, one of the greatest yogis without stepping foot on a yoga mat ever, you know, because it is literally all, right, his will to live and be able to have, like, a higher power meaning, reason why he's here. And then he's been able to help so many people, you know, through his experience and, you know, for how he's living. Because then somebody like me, his sister, literally lived all this, and then I was able to become and do what I do to help, you know, so many people. And he's helping so many people, you know, through his story and living where he is now, that it just shows that, you know, we can't just tap out with what we think, like, so-called the baseline might be. And it really allows us, you know, to push the envelope a bit further and say, well, who are we really? And what are we really? And why are we here? And what's going on here? You know, and it lets us then dive deeper.
And that, you know, other than the mind, because the mind controls everything, it seems, what we think, what our thoughts are saying to ourselves. But that touch, and he had a lot of touch. You know how they say that babies can just shrivel up and die if they're not touched?
Yeah.
And in his case, he had constant touch. And that's love. So with everything, you know, well, as we know, energy is everything. And working that energy with the highest love, divine love, I mean, he's a perfect example how anyone can heal, you know, and be able to function and have a life. It's remarkable.
Yeah, what I always say is the balance of two things happening at the same time, right? Because it's like, let's call it what it is, right? Life can be super hard. It can be devastatingly hard.
Right.
And then the stuff that we each have uniquely, right, that might happen or develop, right, in a human body. And or mind and everything, right, that we're faced with. And then there comes a time that it's a choice to say, right, like, how am I going to go? What way am I going to go? Am I just going to give in and go down, you know, the tubes and just say there's nothing else? There's no other way. And if we're just looking at it this way, right, that there's nothing else to do, nothing else to offer, or can we make it larger? And is there something else maybe outside of the realm that we thought at the time, right, that there is available? And then also that choice that it's so hard and so difficult and all the things you had to go through and still have to go through, but yet somewhere inside you still choose joy at the same time. And that a big piece of healing, you know, right? It's a big piece of healing, because we don't want ourselves to feel like, we're bypassing it, or, you know, it's hard, it's a struggle, and we have things going on, and then feel, though, that we have to stay in that only, and that if all of a sudden we also could feel our happiness and our joy, right, then sometimes that inner landscape feels like an inner betrayal, and sometimes it's hard for people, right, to feel two at the same time or be okay with moving over to say, But I can choose joy in difficult times anyways, or even if, right, however my body feels or what I'm going through or what life is throwing me or anything, right? There's that moment of just how we hold our perception and attitude, though, to say, do we hold the lens? Do we have the lens of saying, but I also choose joy?
Yes. It's a balance, as we know. So you've risen up a number of times from the ashes, and you know, I talk a lot about going to the darkness and being with it instead of running away from it or not wanting to address it and where it's coming from. So in your lifetime, how have you balanced that, you know, the higher self, the higher energy, you know, the divinity of it all, and then worked with day-to-day struggles in on Earth time?
Right. And that goes right back to the holding both at the same time, right? Because we definitely have to just for real say that in order to get there and do it, it certainly didn't come easily, right? And it makes me think of the analogy, or right, the great initiation of the lotus, right? Because the lotus flower definitely comes from, right, and grows in that dark, deep, murky waters, right, the muds. And it literally comes up and starts to have to poke up and rise from that, from all those turbid waters, and literally has to start to rise, right, and come towards the light and come higher and higher until pretty soon it does poke itself out, right, from that kind of environment to reach above water, right, and be the beautiful lotus that it is. And it's why we have the lotus as a symbol in spirituality, right, pretty much as the soul's journey. And so it makes me also remember and know there's a very powerful quote, like a poem from Thich Nhat Hanh, from a spiritual teacher who's passed on. And this really is the essence, right, of what you're talking about when we say about, you know, wanting to be in the feelings and choose, like, how do we go through the hard stuff, you know, and how can we actually get to the other side? And so that that saying that he has, it says that the goodness of suffering is something real, because without suffering, there cannot be happiness. And without mud, there can't be any lotus, right? So if you know how to suffer, suffering's okay. And the moment you have that attitude, then you don't suffer much anymore. And out of that suffering, a lotus flower of happiness can open. And right. All the work I've done on myself and all the work I do with my clients and where they benefit the most is so much in that teachings, because we need to learn how to suffer. And that's like powerful, right? Because we hear that and we can have a resistance to it, right? Or we can be like, oh my God, yes. You know, and a lot of times some of my clients at first feel like, well, why do I want to learn how to suffer? I don't want to suffer. But then the question and the thing posed is, well, you are suffering. Like, you're suffering now. You know what I mean? If you're suffering, then we need to learn how to suffer. Let's bring ourselves, you know, to a place that if we actually didn't learn the tools to know that we were going to possibly could suffer as a human being, right, then it's why we're left with so many who are like, I don't know what to do. I just am drowning. You know, and so when we look and do say, well, we want to know how to drive, we learn how to drive, we want to learn how to cook, right? We need to learn how to cook if we want to cook. It's like, as human beings, with everything that we have to go through in life, with each other, with our own self, our bodies, our mind, our souls, our thoughts, our right interactions, our all of it, it can be hard, right? And then we're like, what tools do you have? Like, what did you ever learn, and how did you ever... Did you, you know, embody anything that would help you when push comes to shove now, right? Because not everybody lived that way growing up, right? Not everybody's playground, like mine throughout the years, was always dunked in these kinds of approaches. And so I learned that it wasn't really normal. Like, to me, it was normal. But then the older I got, I realized people just didn't do this. They just weren't doing what I was doing already at a small age, a lot of us, right? And so therefore, they're, you know, then I'm like, well, then that's how you know you can step in and support. Because, and then start to teach them at no matter what age it is, right, to be able to go, well, what are, you know, what are some tools that we can start to utilize? Where is your mindset beginning from, you know? Is it like, all, like any background at all in, you know, yoga, meditation, or, right, the guided imagery and the EFT tapping and the, right, all the energy psychic realms and the energy management of it all? It's like, there's lots of us that swim in this energy and do this, and then lots that don't. And then it's really when it starts to come to that place, you know, that people need help and people need support and they don't know where to go for this, you know, or what to do. And then it starts to open up a whole new door, right, and a whole new way of living for people that didn't have these tools all along. And so really at whatever age, if you don't have them, the best thing we can teach each other is literally then how can we become resilient? How can we hold and develop more mindfulness to know that as a human being, who we really are and what we can actually go through and make it out the other side of, you know? Because when emotions get really hard, right, and emotions get really hard, if we don't have the tools, we're going to get shaken off the tree. You know what I mean? And so we're like this overwhelming amount of energy that people start feeling in the form of emotions, right, is it ends up being why I do what I do, especially with like the soul coaching for people, because you're literally starting to learn then, well, let me help you learn how to manage your energy, because we're energy and the emotions are energy and our thoughts and patterns and beliefs and definitions that we hold, right? And then that's what allows us an in. So that we can start to learn, well, now we can start to generate ourselves in a way that you might not have known how to do before, or that you may not have viewed yourself or saw yourself in that way. So you didn't have the lens or the focus, right, to begin, say, where's my in? And then once they have that in, then it allows them to realize that when times get tough, if they never learned before, you know, certain tools that they could be utilizing, how do you really get in there and ride out your emotions to know that they'll pass pretty soon, you know, and that you can get to the other side of them. But no one said it was going to be easy. No one said it was going to be easy.
No,
no one said that you weren't going to pass through, right?
Yeah, and we choose this. And for those that may not realize it or even believe it, I really do believe that we choose Earth life, and we are learning through those emotions and
right.
feelings, where when we're in the light, everything is love and divinity. So it's a whole different, it's just a whole different vibration. So we need to take our break.
Yeah.
So everyone stay with us. Don't go away. I'll give out the call-in number when we come back and how to get in touch with Karen Dale.
Experience a different yet profound healing with Reconnective Healing. Includes yet expands beyond any and all known forms of energy healing. The Reconnective Healing Spectrum is comprised of the full healing and evolutionary continuum of energy, light, and information. It allows for healings that are not just physical, not just mental, not just emotional, yet go beyond that to bring healing that includes the evolution of your very being and essence. Deborah Beauvais, trained and certified by world-renowned Dr. Eric Pearl, offers appointment hours at Seekonk Family Chiropractic in Seekonk, Massachusetts. For questions or to set up both distance or local sessions, call Deborah at 508-431-1959. Again, 508-431-1959. Or go to lovebyintuition.com. That's lovebyintuition.com.
Take an unforgettable journey of self-development to achieve new levels of alignment, healing, and life purpose with award-winning author and channel Paul Selig. Led by Paul and his guides, make way for personal growth and overcome obstacles hindering you along the way. Mention discount code DREAM for 20% off when you register for The Upper Room, a 5-day channeled retreat at Omega Institute in Rhinebeck, New York, June 19th to the 24th. Learn more at eomega.org. After narrowly surviving the attack on Sandy Hook Elementary, first grade teacher Caitlin Roy DeBellis was left searching for answers that would never come. Eventually, she chose to focus on questions that could be answered. How do I make sure this tragedy doesn't define us? How do we get our control back? Those two questions led her to found the 501c3 nonprofit organization, Classes for Classes. When gifts poured into their classroom, she decided they would help someone else by paying it forward and being kind. This developed into a social network which allows K-8 classrooms to connect so that every student in the United States can learn these crucial lessons. Classes for Classes' mission is to build students' social-emotional intelligence by connecting them to care. All C4C projects are crowdfunded. Any teacher in the U.S. can visit classesforclasses.org. That's classes, the number 4, classes.org. Sign up today.
Delight your kids with an enchanting journey by reading the Paper Doll Kids children's book by Deborah Beauvais and Janine Sullivan. There's even a catchy tune, Kids for Love Song, produced by Bob Sherwood and sung by kids just like yours. The story weaves around 7 paper dolls flying around the world doing good deeds as they bring important attention to our endangered animal friends. There's even a magical ring with a universal message. Kids become interested in service projects, action through compassion, and planting seeds that nurture positive change. The Paper Doll Kids and Kids for Love Song are a production of the Kids for Love Project. Get the book now on Amazon Kindle and the song on CD Baby or iTunes.
This is Dream Vision 7 Radio Network, uniting mankind with universal love. Our shows are created from the heart, bringing each listener to a place of divine enlightenment. Breathe, relax, and enjoy. Let life flow.
And we are back, and this is a live show, so you can call in. Bob is in the house and takes your calls, 833-220-1200, 833-220-1200. And it's a gift to be able to call in and talk with KARENDAYAL’S. I mean, just you can call her afterwards, of course, but where it's live, it would be a gift to you to be able to call, have a comment, ask a question, because she is so special. And I love all my guests, and I'm honored to have them, but KARENDAYAL’S is just, she is something else, for lack of another term. And I should also, I should mention to everyone that with all her modalities, she pulls from all these different pieces that she has been skilled with for so many years, and she's an inspired speaker. She is a Reiki master teacher. She does EFT, Ayurveda wisdom. She blends that in, soul clearings. So it's just about everything that you would need. And KARENDAYAL’S, why don't you tell us a bit about when someone comes to you for wanting to go into doing the soul work?
Oh yeah, exactly. Because I think right before the break, you said a beautiful nugget right before we had to take a commercial break, and it was all about you know, how you were going into the essence, you know, about being going into the positive and going into that love frequency. And what I really wanted to touch on as well is that what I do in the soul coaching so much with people, that because it's just incredible results, is that it's not a quick to bypass in any way. And then that is what makes it so refreshing to my clients, because what happens is, right, is that, like we said at the beginning, let's call it what it is. Life is hard and can be hard. And how do we get it to not be so hard, right? How can we vibrate in a way that hopefully we don't have those struggles anymore and we can release them? Or when we do, how can we handle them? And the whole point is, right, when people are always saying, just be positive, you know, and just release and let it go, you know, and things like that. And when you are struggling and when you are hurting and grieving, it's the last freaking thing you want to hear. I'm sorry. You know what I mean? We cannot bypass. And there's also a quote that says, like, that I love so much, right, that says, you can't pull a flower up to make it grow faster, right? So it's about honoring.
I love that.
It's about honoring. Because whatever it is that we're going through at that moment in time, it's precious. And we honor right where we are. And when we know what grief feels like and sadness feels like and great pain feels like, confusion, right, doubting, spinning, any on any level, and we can't just go from there and then all of a sudden just be like, oh, well, let's just insert some positive affirmations, right? Only because then that other part of us that is absolutely for real feels betrayed. It feels like, how can I literally be honoring, you know, if I feel this way, or maybe it's over a loss of somebody or a loss of something in your own life, or, right, great change, no matter what the topic is, a job, a marriage, anything, is lost. And so how quickly we shift, change, and move as human beings, and then nobody gets a middle. And sometimes you don't get that transition that you needed. You know, like a threshold, you just got launched right into it. And these are the things that we continue to carry as human beings right into the next thing. And then we wonder why we're so accumulated that one day, right, people just pop. And so The soul coaching that I do is so beautiful because it incorporates all the modalities that are evidence-based and all of my wisdom and intuitive nature that comes up as I start to interact with your soul and start to interact with your system. And your system and your soul is what literally guides the whole entire process, because then you start to learn about you and we can map you out. And then as the more that you learn about you and you literally learn how you're operating, and what your actual thinking patterns are the resistances and the blocks that we'll never do and go to on our own, then it allows us to start to, you know, enjoy the process a little bit more, where we're honoring everything as it is and then little by little layering and layering, right, to be able to shift you vibrationally and move the energy so that it is healing and it is transformative and it is, so we can bring it back into your empowerment channel, right? But we can't always rip it, right? We can't be like in one feeling state, which is absolutely for real for somebody, right? And then just automatically say, well, you, it'll be fine. Time will pass and you'll feel better, right? I mean, there's a process in the middle. There's a deep process in the middle. And that process is what I am so honored to be able to work with human beings with, because that's the process we do. And it's through all my lenses. Like I say, it's like a viewmaster. Remember the viewmaster? You put the slide in and you just click away and it's changes regularly. And so that's like, I'm in and out of different lenses. Why everyone's like, oh my gosh, they're like, you cover it all. I mean, I could be working on the physical human body with massage, moving it energetically, right, with the energy work and the healing, and then, you know, teaching us the yoga and the physical bodies of movement, going through breath, meditation, and then what it takes to really go into the EFT process, the emotional freedom technique, that's tapping, people know it as, because it moves the energy in our meridian body, but works with the brain and the nervous system. In order to help literally like reshift, recreate, you know, the inner landscape, if you will, and get us out of that stress, anxiety cocktail that rises in us. And all of a sudden, the nervous system does what? It either fights, it either starts running and flees, or it freezes. And this is what we're doing as human beings. And that's why when my clients come to me, whether it's to heal in different ways or they're spinning and it's all about their procrastination about stuff, right? You get in there because it's unique. We have universal stuff for sure as human beings that are very universal on how we're thinking, feeling, moving, acting, behaving. And then we also know we all have the individual journey, right, for our own personal life on how we've been living. And then that's what makes it unique to that person. So when we line people up, say it is procrastination, right, that we're working on with the client at the time, we can't just say, oh, well, you're procrastinating. So, I don't know, just make a better list and give them another to-do, you know, and say just the moment you feel like you're going to procrastinate, just get in there and just, like, take a step and, right, do it anyways. It's like if they could do that, they'd be doing that already. But when we really start to see it from a nervous system level, we realize the freezing, the pausing that people do, right? You might have a book you want to write or a job thing you have to do or homework or whatever it might be, right? Why is it that some people can just get it done? And then what is happening to the ones that are like, oh, I got this task to do, and never mind, they're going to go do laundry instead, right? Or go watch TV or go take a walk, or right? Every time they've got that one task they want to do, right, they tap out, right? And they're like, nah, right, never mind, I'm going to go do this instead. So what is happening? Like, what's happening inside of that person? So in the soul coaching sessions that I do, we like it, it's amazing how we just, it reveals itself when we get it, because there's a lot of things that are happening. And we got to get in there. And when we get in there, I'm your river guide that helps, you know, go to those places. Like, where do we need to go? Where is it inside of you that we need to go in order to heal it? And then when we get to that place, right, then that's when it can transform, and then that's when we can bring it into the empowerment channel. That's where long-lasting change happens and comes from. Right. So it's not a quick fix, where sometimes that's why other people are like, oh, my God, I was doing this other modality for 7 years or this one for this long, and I had 1 hour with you, KARENDAYAL’s, one, and it went boom. You know what I mean? Like, we just got to it. And so when we're in the energetic field and in your soul, because your soul is not a part, it's all the overlays that are over all these things in us as human beings that then we lovingly start to, right, take off the overlays, and we start to move the energy that's stuck in there, and then it starts to open up to start, right, to be able to move past where you once were stuck or spinning or doubting, right, or didn't know. So there's so many layers. Some people are just there to try and be like, who am I? Like, who am I now? You know, they've lived their life a certain way for so long, and they can feel their shift and change, that there's something different for them. Or people are going through different loss and grieving, and some people are, you know, are going through divorces and or want to get a divorce and haven't come to terms with it yet and want more clarity. It's like the human condition is what it is, and all of the stuff that we face as a human being is that we need a way, right, to be able to say, how do I, when everyone's always like, but how, right? Because we're told, oh, well, just do this, or just breathe, or just do some affirmations, right? But you need some guidance. You need some guidance. And that's why me, is when I say now, after all my years of, you know, the modalities I do, and I have, you know, to say I'm your life river guide to help you get to you so that you can navigate your life. I'm helping you to get inside of you to be who you are by taking these overlays off and empowering you so that the beliefs that you maybe once had, the definitions that you once hold, were outdated, you know, and definitely need a software upgrade. And then that's what we're doing in these sessions. But there's a process. There's creative processes that go along with it. And the actual energetic work that's happening inside through the various things, that then now it makes sense to people, because they're like, oh, because I couldn't do this on my own. I can't just sit here and look at in the mirror one more time, some people tell me, with a sticky note on it, and I'm just saying the same affirmation over and over again. And I'm like, because you don't believe it, right? There's the discord, because you read an affirmation, and then the people that aren't really vibrating at that affirmation is why. You know, and then, but there's work to be done to eventually shift that vibration so you do vibrate it, right? And then all of a sudden you're like, I say this statement and I believe it now, right? Or we say a statement, right, and we're like, no, I don't believe that. So we want to know that as information, because then that's where I go as your coach to help you go in, right, and be able to look at the ones that, you know, that you don't believe, or that I say this, but I believe this instead, right? This is what I believe, or this is my definition over it, and then that's why they're doing what they're doing. And then if we can help them, you know, get on the other side and start to align it with their values now and things like that, the inner landscape starts to shift, because it's all about energy management. It's all about energy management. And so when we can start to see ourselves or our life, too, just to realize that, when I use the term, you know, like we say, oh, there's that very, how do I want to say, the Tamastic way. It's like we're kind of sitting in mud, you know, I don't want to do anything. I feel a little lethargic, maybe a little depressed, you know, that kind of energy. And then
I think there's a lot of fear to that, too, if I may say. A lot of people are carrying fear, and sometimes they're either stuck in the mud, or even, you know, they may hurt their leg or something that prevents them to move forward. And when you make that energetic connection, this happened because I'm not moving forward, and why am I not wanting to move forward? It's another, another way to go
deep
into
layers.
That
there's different approaches. Yeah, different approaches and many layers to be addressed. Because if you start moving through one layer of the body, because we're so multi-layered, you might move through the physical, and then it might not be on the physical level. Then you kind of move through the emotional, and it might not be on the emotional. And then you move through the little mental more, it might not be on the mental. And then you might go into space, and then you might start to go into, like, the multi-dimensional aspects that could be tied from a past life. I mean, it's literally all these layers.
Complex. There's
and
a
when
lot
we
of complexities there.
All the layers. Yeah. And when we go through all the layers, though, and know that we can have a guide to bring you through them, then that's why I say it's like you don't even need to know the depth of what's happening sometimes, right? To order to literally what you know is how you get back home to you. And if you know how to get back home to you, then that's where I always say, now here you are, right? Like, now this is where you're navigating from. And people are like, I have never been here before. a lot of people are like, I have never actually felt this way before, because a lot of people don't feel, And so you have to help get them out of the intellect and bring them back into their bodies and bring them back into the feeling state. Because sometimes, that's, if they're not even in that place, then they can't. It's hard to heal if you can't feel. So you have to be brought back into the feel. And it's scary to feel, right? So then again, the nervous system will tap out and be like, I'm not going to go there because I'm not safe. It's scary, So that's what healing is. But healing can be very fun. And it's also, no one said that the middle part, or what have you, maybe isn't going to reveal, like a lot of truth to be like, whoa, this is like, now we're in the rapids, and I got to get through this. But if we learn the ways, then that's what makes it beautiful, is that we actually have tools, and the right tools. Like, I always use this example. I say, if you have a picture to hang on the wall and you have a nail, then, you go get a hammer, you can put it right in. But you can go grab a screwdriver and you can use the back of the screwdriver, right, and bang it in. But what's the experience going to be like, right? So you would want to grab the hammer. So basically it's like, what approach is needed when, and to know that that these different modalities and something like the soul coaching that I do, it's so amazing because it brings in a bunch of different lenses, and it allows, that person to really have some for real long-lasting transformation and healing that stays with them forever.
Right.
That stays with them. It isn't like a let me do it now and then, a week later, it's like, you didn't fill the drain pipe, so to speak. You know what I mean? It's like these things that we do because it's so in our soul and so in the energy body. It's really like the missing link. It's the missing link.
Yes. Hold that thought. We need to take our last break. Everyone stay with us, and I will give Karendayal’s information out when we come back.
Take a journey to a place of the divine love within with Deborah Beauvais on the Love by Intuition show, Monday through Friday at 6 p.m. and 6 a.m. Eastern. Our message is love in the purest form. The light within us all is a guide to recall our beginning, to learn to love self and humankind, and to feel the higher power of our own divinity. To attract love, one needs to be love. Come join us and step into this glorious vibration called love.
Delight your kids with an enchanting journey by reading the Paper Doll Kids Children's Book by Deborah Beauvais and Janine Sullivan. There's even a catchy tune, Kids for Love Song, produced by Bob Sherwood and sung by kids just like yours. The story weaves around seven paper dolls flying around the world doing good deeds as they bring important attention to our endangered animal friends. There's even a magical ring with a universal message. Kids become interested in service projects, action through compassion, and planting seeds that nurture positive change. The Paper Doll Kids and Kids for Love Song are a production of the Kids for Love Project. Get the book now on Amazon Kindle and the song on CD Baby or iTunes.
Are miracles real? Can you move from mayhem to miracles? 30 prominent authors say yes as they share their high fives and down lows of challenges, abuse, addiction, and love. Experience hope, the magic elixir of miracles, through the personal stories of New York Times best-selling authors James Redfield, Dr. Bernie Siegel, Sister Jenna, Reverend Temple Hayes, and many more. If you like bestsellers, Chaos to Clarity, and Crappy to Happy, you'll love Crying and Laughing Through Mayhem to Miracles. Sacred Stories of Transformational Hope, available now on Amazon and in bookstores worldwide.
Looking for a fun and relaxing getaway? Omega Rest and Rejuvenation Retreats are a great way to unwind and renew your spirit. Sit and read in the garden, explore the woodland trails, or try a daily yoga or meditation class. You can stretch your body, quiet your mind, and do as much or as little as you choose. Located in Rhinebeck, New York, just 90 miles north of New York City, Omega's natural environment and quiet pace allow for extraordinary experiences to unfold. Learn more at eomega.org or call 800-944-1001.
It's a child's job to play, to learn, and to have fun. It's an adult's job to keep them safe. Did you know that 1 in 4 girls and 1 in 6 boys will be sexually abused before the age of 18? Every day, families enter the Children's Advocacy Center because of child's courage to tell someone what happened to them. Keeping our children safe starts with a conversation. This is Michelle Aranger, Executive Director of the Children's Advocacy Center. Learn more on how to keep your child safe. Visit cacofbc.org. This message made possible by the Fall River Rotary Club.
This is Dream Vision 7 Radio Network, uniting mankind with universal love. Our shows are created from the heart, bringing each listener to a place of divine enlightenment. Breathe, relax, and enjoy. Let life flow.
And welcome back. The number here is 833-220-1200. You'll have to act fast if you want to call in because the time is flying. Bob is in the house and he'll answer your call and put you through. 833-220-1200. To check out Karen Dayall, Devi, you go on her site and it's Karen with a K, Dayall, D-A-Y-A-L, Devi, D as in dog, EVI.com, KarenDayallDevi.com. And you can call her office number. It's 508-252-WELL, W-E-L-L. Again, 508-252-WELL, W-E-L-L. And Karen Dayall, I wanted to, bring it back to that. As far as you had mentioned earlier about suffering, and we all do suffer, but we don't have to stay in that suffering mode. Some people, I think even in a religious environment, may say that, yes, because Jesus, suffered, we're supposed to suffer. And I'm a big believer that when something is happening that's really heavy and dark, go there and be with it and just roll around in it, but then, rise up from that. You do not have to suffer from that any longer.
And
Could you tell me your thoughts around that?
Yeah, well, that's why people need tools, because there are some people that don't know how to rise up from it, right? Once we're in it, it can make us feel like we're drowning, right? So if we don't have the tools and the support we need, then we're going to feel like we're drowning. And so that's why it's important, to get your support team to, reach out for help and what have you, right? No matter how small or how big, suffering is a little suffering and can be really big suffering. And then we know then what lane we need to get into. But I know that the lane that I help my clients in, they're so grateful and happy that I get to see them move from one way to another way, because it helps them with their stress and their anxious anxiety and procrastination, or when they feel stuck or any feelings of, the spinning and relationship issues and relationships to themselves and relationships to others get better. That's what we're doing, right? Because we're using this soul self-mastery work and the soul coaching work that I do to literally manage the tension in your bodies and the worries in the mind, right? And because all emotions and thoughts are literally forms of energy, that's why the energy needs to be moved and managed. And your situations and your emotions that are for real need to be honored. They need to be heard, they need to be moved, they need to be honored. And you get a better understanding of why they're there, or, you know, and how you can shift them, because it's always the how, right? It's the middle. It's like, yes. I'm here, but I want to be
interject,
over there.
Karen.
Yeah.
If I may interject, we have a caller. Okay. Janine, are you there?
Hello. I am. Hello, Deborah.
Good.
Hello,
welcome,
Karen Dayall.
Hi.
I have a question.
Show.
Thank you. I have a question. I'm trying to formulate it as I dialed in. I've spoken to a few people lately that are just so devastated over the last 2 years that have been difficult for most people. And yet, when I speak to them, I get the sense that really so many things have been triggered from previous years in their life. And I wonder if you could speak about that a bit as it relates to people who think
absolutely
their struggle is 2 years old when it's really 10, 15, 20 years old. Thank you.
Yeah, sure. Because I think that it lives in us, right? Whatever it is that lives in us already, and like you had said, people get triggered. We can have something happen in the now moment, and what it does is it meets up against what's already in there. Boom, it triggers it. And then it kind of pushes things up, I always say, like a push pop. You know, the actual ice cream push pop, and you push mm-hmm. the thing up from the bottom, and then the ice cream rises, right? And that's what happens, right? So when we start to know that the fear that we're seeing rise in people now, right, it's like all of these things that end up, it triggers everyone differently. The isolation part could trigger some people. Some people actually liked it, right? We know that all of a sudden some people were thriving in their jobs, others literally lost their business, right? So we've got all these different shifting energies taking place and a lot of change happening at a super warp speed. And again, it goes to back to each person individually, whatever it is, right, inside of us already, and then how we're each getting triggered in our own unique way and how it is affecting, right, all of us and our nervous systems, right? Because a lot of it is the troubled times, and it's very difficult. And without the tools and the resources in that lane, right, then you're going to feel more hopeless, and you're going to feel more fear, right? And then it can just get larger. And so that's why work like this, and a lot of people are doing work like this, if people don't know about it, right, then they won't be able to get into that kind of lane that can help them and support them, right, to be able to know that when they're getting triggered in that way, right, what do we do with our stuff instead of it just being there? And then that's why a modality like the EFT tapping and breath work and meditation and things are there for people, so that when you learn the ways, it helps create that container within you to help navigate the flow that's happening, right? Because each one of us definitely are experiencing something different during these challenging times that we're all in.
Well, thank you. I love the several words you use, navigate especially. I think we
that
do
helpful?
Need to navigate with new tools.
We
thank
need
you.
Navigating. Yes, we do need new tools. And we need more. There's a bunch of things, though, that are happening, right, that all need to happen. Because I know some people are all just running through. We need the love, right? We need love. But also there's a lot of things happening for people that we also need to get angry about, right? And it's okay to get angry about it because it's energy and it needs to move, right? So when somebody loses their job or was made to shut down or, right, have to, like, you're getting great loss, it's a natural thing that the human being and body is going to feel. And we must never just stuff it and bypass it, right? And then just say to those people, well, you're just supposed to be over here or get it, right? Everybody's in a different lane, right?
Mm-hmm.
And without the tools, the proper tools, and without the proper way to navigate it, right, if we have the proper tools and we have help navigating it, it can start to become a better experience, right? Even though we have to keep paddling, right? Like some of us have to paddle really hard right now. Others are kind of floating, are they not, right? Everybody's like, we're in this together, but yet everybody definitely is in all different places with it, right? And
true
the
enough.
Ones that are feeling their stuff, oof, we need, like, we're here to help, you know? We're here to help because it absolutely is a triggering time we're living in now, right?
It is. Absolutely. Well, thank you. I found what you had to say very enlightening and liberating. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you for calling in. Okay, Karendayal, we only have a minute and a half. So what would you, in a sentence or two, what would you like to leave the listeners with? And before you go, I would like to say go on her site, KarendayalDevi.com, and her phone number. And if you call her, you will be so grateful that you did this. 508-252-WELL. All right. How would you like to leave?
Thank you, Deborah. Oh, I'm going to leave with another quote, because when you hear this quote, now you're going to understand the work that I do. It's a Robert Coelho quote that says, maybe the journey isn't so much about becoming anything. Maybe it's about unbecoming everything that isn't really you, so you can become who you were meant to be in the first place.
That is the juice.
That's the juice, the energy, the wisdom that gets unfolded. It's exactly what gets unfolded when you're with me. When you choose you finally, the day comes and you say, no, I choose me, and I'm going to start to dive into the soul coaching work with you, Karendayal. That's the juice. That's the wisdom. That's the energy that we start to dive into to get you back to you and who you really are.
Yes.
So you can just live and navigate life every day because, right, it can be good, it can be hard, it can be challenging. And when we are equipped, then the ride can be different.
Right. And you don't have to guess when you know the truth of who you are. You know you from the root up. So, and that in itself is a gift. When you really know yourself, the truth of who you are, and you love it. You love yourself, you love that we can always do better, but you love who you are, the good,
bad,
the ugly, all of it.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
But it takes people a process, and that's what I help you through is the process so that it becomes for real and that you're living it for real and not just intellectually living it, but for real you feel it and you're living it as for real.
You're walking it. Yes, so you're being it. So with that said, we'll have you back. And with that said, everyone, until we come together in love again, au revoir.
Thank you.
Thank you, Karendayal. I love you.
Thank you. Love you.
Are you seeking a clearer path to love? Then tune in to the Love by Intuition show next week. All designed to your highest good. To contact Deborah Beauvais, owner of Empowered Connections, call her at 508-226-1723. That's 508-226-1723. Or link on to lovebyintuition.com. Remember, we are all one, and we are all part of the miracle of love.
This is Dream Vision 7 Radio Network, uniting mankind with universal love. Our shows are created from the heart, bringing each listener to a place of divine enlightenment. Breathe, relax, and enjoy. Let life flow.